Hello guys, in this video I'll explain the condition of pure rolling on a moving surface. So you can see that in the previous video we have already learned about the pure rolling condition on the ground, and now in this video we are going to learn about the pure rolling condition on a moving surface. Now there is a ring which is moving with some velocity v naught. Its center is moving with velocity v naught, and this ring is rotating about its central axis with angular velocity omega. This ring is situated on a plank which is already moving with a velocity vp. Now we have already discussed that for pure rolling on any surface, the velocity of point of contact on the body and the point of contact on that surface should be equal, which means that the relative velocity of point of contact on both the body and the surface must be zero. So by using this condition we can say that the velocity of point A would be v naught plus r omega, because center is already moving with velocity v naught, and this complete object is rotating about the center with an angular velocity of omega. So velocity of point A would be v naught plus r omega, and velocity of point B would be v naught minus r omega, because v naught is in the forward direction while r omega is in the reverse direction for point B. Now we have assumed that v naught is greater than r omega, and this is due to the fact that we know that we have to equate this velocity v naught minus r omega with vp, and vp is in the forward direction. Therefore we have to assume that vb is also in the forward direction, and for that v naught should be greater than r omega. So for pure rolling condition, the velocity of point B lying on the ring and the velocity of point B lying on the wedge or that plank should be equal. So VB should be equal to VP. So V naught minus R omega should be equal to VP. So this is the condition of pure rolling on this moving surface. Now if this moving surface was moving in the reverse direction, in the backward direction, then we would have written the velocity of point B in the reverse direction, considering the fact that r omega would be greater than v naught in that case, because we have to write the velocity of point B in the backward direction. So we are assuming that r omega is greater than v naught. Now to establish the condition for pure rolling in this case, we can say that velocity of point B vb should be equal to velocity of plank in the reverse direction. So VB should be equal to VP, and R omega minus V naught is equal to VP. Now let's move on the slipping part. Now why do we say that the rolling, in the case of rolling, the point of contact is at rest? So we say this due to the fact that at the point of contact, each contact point is changing, but none of them is moving. But in the case of slipping, this contact point is also moving with respect to the surface. Now if the velocity of this contact point is in the forward direction, and v naught is greater than r omega, then it would be in forward direction, then this case would be called as forward slipping. And if the velocity of this point of contact is in the reverse direction, which would be in the case when r omega would be greater than v naught, then this is called as reverse slipping or backward slipping. So this was the complete analysis of rolling on a moving surface and slipping conditions. In the next video, we'll discuss more about rolling. Thank you.